Hola, community, I'm Pablo Vasquez. You know what's new in Blender today? A new modifier for volume objects. Yes, obvious volume objects. If you're familiar with this new object type that was added a few versions ago in Blender, it's available when you do like Shift A, add a volume, and you can import OpenVDV, which was the most useful so far. But now, when you add an empty one, you can have modifiers, which we're gonna see in a moment. So, why I have this file open here? Well, this is a character from a film by Studio Ghibli. It's Howl's Moving Castle by Miyazaki. I tried to make this character because it's a little fire with eyes. So I thought it was like a great way to mix grease pencil with, you know, with like some volumes. So I started playing with the shader, and then I realized that the volume shader was a bit more complex for my knowledge to do. So the way I achieved it was basically just having in the volume, wait, select here. So, well, I mean, I made a mess. Look at the experiment. This is okay. This is not, this is like showing dirty laundry. All right. So in the volume, I was kind of using a mix of colors based on a ramp, based on the some kind of position of the shaders. Anyway, way too complex. I mean, it's a cartoony effect, so maybe that's what I was going for. But now we can do it in a more simple way, because I can take this shape and I can make a volume out of it with a new volume object. So let's add a new object. So I'm going to add a new object with Shift A, volume, empty. This volume object now is empty, it's down here, but it has its own settings. That's the cool thing about being its own object type, is that it can have its own modifiers that are different from meshes or any other curves or any other object. So, add a modifier, the only one in the list so far, you're not gonna get lost, is mesh to volume. Add it there, there's a few options here, you can control the density and the object. This is the main one. So, as an object, I want to have this object, the geo body, right? So I'm gonna select it, geo body, and voila, that is it. So if I even hide the geo body, you're gonna see it better. And that's it. That's it. Just works. TM. It's the it's a mesh. The mesh that I had even animated. It follows the volume follows the shape. That is amazing. And because it's an actual volume, I can have like a volume shader here, can make it a bit more red. And for the light inside, I can just simply add a lamp because it's a volume and it gets lit from inside. Isn't that amazing? So I can add, I don't know, maybe there are more fancy ways of doing this, but this way I can just, yeah, start playing with the shape, and it's a volume, so things can go inside, I guess. Yeah, wow. Okay, that looks creepy. Oh, behold the Lord, Susanna, the Lady Susanna. All right, it's just too much. Okay, cool. Isn't that amazing? It's a new modifier for a new object type. This is awesome. I want to see more modifiers. What kind of modifiers do you think this type of volume object could have? It's awesome. Anyway, have fun, play with it. It's available on the daily build already. So go to builder.blender.org to get it. On the wiki, there are a few notes. What is new too, that is that now you can see the outlines in the viewport of these kind of objects. You can even select by clicking on them, which before it wasn't really possible. And you can also, it also supports lower resolution in the viewport. So what you see in the viewport can be a bit less resolution than in the render. Just so it's faster on your viewport, like subdivision levels or simplify. Anyway, have fun, and I will see you again in the next video. Bye bye.